In this lesson, we'll look at Google Play from a developer's perspective. You'll learn about the critical elements to include in your Google Play app listing and how to get your app discovered and downloaded by Android users. Since this is a course about development and not marketing, we won't go through all the information available about promoting your apps. Google has recently added a lot of good information and instructions about Google Play on the developer's website under distribution. The homepage is shown here. There's great information on app visibility, monetization, distribution, publishing, promoting, app quality, how to spotlight your app, and open distribution. And a link to this page is included in the graphic here. I'll leave it to you to go through these pages on your own. I suggest you take a first spin through them after we've finished this lesson. In this lesson, we'll look at aspects of listing your app on Google Play that are the most pertinent to you as a developer and the one who may be tasked with registering on Google Play and uploading your apps to their servers. We'll address the mechanics of uploading your app and its graphic and text elements in a coming lesson. So let's go through the main elements on an app listing webpage on Google Play. The app name, which appears here, and you might include it on your main graphic here, is one of the most important elements, and we'll take a close look at key app name characteristics later in this lesson. The publisher's name will link all the apps you develop to your company, and it's one way for users to find your apps. The icon appears not only on the Google Play page, but it's also used by users to launch your app from their launch screens. But don't skimp on developing this graphic. It's an important element in your app promotion. Try to make it fun and easily recognizable and pertinent to your app. The main graphic shown here should be an attractive representation of the purpose of your app. If you don't have the skills to develop it yourself, consider using a professional or purchasing a graphic at a source like Getty Images, for which I've included a link here. The description of your app serves a couple of purposes. Information for the user and keywords for Google Play to find your app based on user searches. We'll look at the app description in more detail in this lesson shortly. You should include a number of screenshots in your listing to demonstrate a bit of how your app works and to show its features. Don't skimp on screenshots. You'll use Eclipse DDMS to capture the screenshots from your app. Including a video, if you can, is a good idea. Users love videos. They're a great way to show off your app. And finally, upload information about what's new in the latest release of your app. So that's a quick overview of the elements of your app listing that you'll upload to Google Play. Now I'm going to go through some excerpts from a presentation I made to the San Francisco Android User Group in December of 2011. The presentation is about how you can approach improving your app ranking in Google Play search results. The full video lasts about 30 minutes, and you can watch it by following the link here in the lower left. Now, in 2011, Google Play was called the Android Market. The name has changed, but the fundamental ideas behind it are the same. The conclusions reached in the video and the presentation I'll go through here are based on an analysis of hundreds of search results and discussions with dozens of developers about their experiences. On the Android Developers website, there's a discussion of app visibility, including search. In this excerpt from the website, you can see how Google describes their search algorithm, using powerful heuristics to find the most relevant and popular apps. Not surprisingly, Google doesn't share any details about exactly how the results are calculated. On this page, there's also a discussion of their top charts and lists. And there's a link to this page over on the left. If you can get your app into one of the top lists, it's a big leg up on the competition. However, by my calculation, the top lists cover maybe 10,000 apps. And this is a small percentage of the 700,000 or so apps currently on Google Play. Most apps are discovered through search. And following the 80-20 rule, at most 20% of apps get most of the attention. So how do you increase your chances of appearing near the top of an app search? One important factor is your app name, and this can make a big difference in the success of your app. Here's what we learned about app names. The search algorithm is parsing app names and performing spell correction. So for users to find a specific app, they have to use quotes around the words in the name, and most searchers won't do this. One impact of this is that plays on words and abstract names may not be as effective as plain words in names for search purposes. Let's look at an example to demonstrate this. The search on talk radio brought up these results. Now, I'd been following Stitcher, and their name used to be just Stitcher instead of Stitcher Radio News and Talk. That's a pretty abstract name. And they were showing up somewhere around number 14, 15 in results. They added the words radio, news, and talk to their name, and they immediately started to move up in results. Here you can see they're number 4. I checked most recently, and they've moved up to number 2 just behind TuneIn Radio, which has many more downloads than they do. And notice that all the higher placed results that you see here have the terms talk or radio in their names. And keywords aren't just important in the app name. Google now seems to be placing special importance on the first few lines or first paragraph of the description. Keywords are also important in the body of the description, but due to keyword spamming, Google seems to be placing less emphasis on them. As a note, Google has recently implemented a rules policy against keyword spamming. And Google's also added a measure of app stickiness using a proprietary formula that measures recent installs versus uninstalls, and it can be visualized by using the recent installs chart on the web version of Google Play. A chart line moving up would show an app with a good sticky factor. Now, this example of a search on the term coffee shows how Google might be combining rank factors to order results. Recency is shown by the 30-day charts we just looked at. Total downloads is taken off the app webpage. The rating is shown by the stars. The name checkmark indicates whether the search term coffee is in the name, and paid indicates whether there's a charge for the app. Now, Google seems to be placing some paid apps highly in search results in order to encourage app purchases. Now, based on these results, it looks like recent activity and keywords in the name have a significant effect on search rankings. Notice that the result, Brain Cafe, with over 1 million downloads, is only ranked 3rd, probably because it doesn't have the word coffee in the name, although it has cafe, which is close. So that's an overview of Google Play and app search rankings. If you haven't already looked through the Google Play sections of the Android Developers website, you might want to do that before moving on to the next lesson.